Can you play in virtual reality on an integrated GPU with enough performance not to die of motion sickness? The requirements for virtual reality are significantly higher than regular gaming, and low performance can have some nasty consequences. I have already proved how even something as humble as a dedicated GT 1030 is able to play a couple of intense games with the right adjustments. Now, I am yet to find an Intel HD powerful enough to run any VR title that I own, but then I remembered the Ryzen 2200G. On my video on this $100 GPU, I was surprised at how far its integrated Vega graphics could go compared to any other integrated GPU that I had ever tried. And so the question takes shape. Superhot VR was the lightest of the proper virtual reality games that I tried. So, with the proper overclock, could the 2200G run it on a low resolution? On my last video on the topic, I had a bit of a miniature rant regarding overclocking. As a ton of you were quick to point out, my issues were happening due to a low quality VRM. I decided to put yet more money on this project, thank you to everyone who has donated for this, and change the motherboard for this Gigabyte G8AB350M, which is a bit more expensive than my previous components. I'm not going to claim to be an expert on overclocking, obviously, but the lesson learned from here is that if you plan to overclock, you might want to have something better than Amazon's cheapest option, even if it supports overclocking on paper. With that done, I turned to the cooling. Longtime viewers might remember that time when I used a Chinese all-in-one water cooler to overclock an all-modded Xeon CPU, and some noticed that I was sent two of those, and that I never used this one, which is Ryzen compatible, so let's do that. Finally, I had a short conversation with the folks at BitPhoenix, the brand of PC cases, which ended up with them sending me a review unit of their Enso case with, I kid you not, a bunch of LED strips, and I thought to myself, why not? So this is how the overclocking Ryzen PC looks like. Wait a minute, I just built a PC from new components, that is liquid cooled, that is about to be overclocked, and it's on a case filled with lights. Oh god, is this becoming a mainstream PC gaming channel?
Ooh, nothing under 90 FPS can be allowed.
Huh? What?
4K is the only acceptable resolution.
Oh no, it's the ghost of the PC gaming master race.
8 gigabytes of RAM? Don't make me laugh. Ho ho ho.
With all the components set, all that was needed was to overclock the Ryzen, which can easily be done with the Ryzen Master Utility. I'm going to focus on overclocking the GPU, which starts on 1.1 GHz. Gigahertz? Gigahertz? GHz. Without touching any of the important voltage values, I was easily able to reach 1.35 GHz. Not bad. Any more than that and I get a blue screen, which gets fixed by raising the SoC voltage to 1.25. From what I have been able to research, 1.2 is the top recommended safe value for that, but I'm sure we can risk an extra 0.05 volts without many issues, right? This tiny change allowed me to get all the way to 1.6, which is really good. Any more than that and we start seeing some pretty bad artifacting, which can be fixed by raising the GFX voltage. But that overheats the whole thing, and it starts throttling, so it seems we have hit the limits of the cooling. Still, a 500 MHz jump is nothing to laugh at. Let's test it. For the VR headset, I will use this HP Windows Mixed Reality that I got for cheap for my VR video in the corner. SteamVR did not initially seem to work with this iGPU, but after disabling direct mode, we were on business. Despite my best attempts, Skyrim VR was not within the realm of possibility, but using the resolution scaler and SteamVR, I'm putting it all the way down. Superhot actually gave some interesting results. This game doesn't look half bad on a really low resolution. In Hellset, it has a solid visual design that actually allows you to recognize what is actually happening, even though the resolution is much lower, which is a huge advantage it has compared to Skyrim or Fallout. So it has excellent performance, and it absolutely, it's still very much recognizable when you're playing on a low resolution. Okay, that didn't went. Oh wow, that was perfect. Come on. That doesn't look good. Okay. Wow, this is amazing. It's hard to believe that this is an integrated GPU. They have really come a long way. This could potentially be a fantastic new use case for... okay, that was terrible. Oh, freaks. Oh god, no. Oh, okay, that actually worked. Done. Oh, come on. The only game where speedrunning is actually exercise. Ha! Ha! Okay. I think I'm done. I think that's enough.
So if you want to get away with experiencing virtual reality on an APU, you kinda can, under some specific circumstances. But if you want to get away with making the whole world better without spending any money, you will call me a madman, but I'm not, because of Tab for a Cause. Tab for a Cause is a plugin that substitutes your new tab page for a nice looking dashboard with some ads. Money from those ads goes to charity, and you can even point out which charities you want to contribute to the most. So install it, start opening tabs, and help in the world. Since its creation, it has raised over $500,000 to charity, and with your help, it can do way more. Check it out in the link in the description. Thank you to them for sponsoring this video, and to these people for Patreon, and huge thanks to fellow creator Epos Mox for making the voice of the Ghost of the PC Master Race.